Hello and welcome to another episode of Let's Fly. Today I want to show you how I use Air Manager in my cockpit. And first of all, I do not get anything from Sim Innovations who create Air Manager. I have bought all my licenses by myself, but some people ask me for going more into detail with it. Well, first of all, why do I use Air Manager? Well, that's pretty easy to explain. I want to display my instruments on various computers that are not my main flight sim PC to save performance on it, and as I know there are two options, probably there are more, but I only know those two, it's SimVim and Air Manager. SimVim is a great software, but it has two disadvantages for me. First, there are not that many instruments available, and second, I want to be able to switch between the simulators, and SimVim, as I know, only works with X-Plane. When you use Air Manager, there are several pieces of software. First of all, Air Manager itself. This is the one to create your panels and to run it. Air Manager itself is available for Windows, Mac and Linux, and I use Air Manager to configure my panels and my instruments. The second is Air Player. If you're running more than one computer with instruments, you use Air Player for the remote computers. It is cheaper and only displays the instruments. There is no configuration to UI, so you need a license of Air Manager for it to run. AirPlayer also runs on PC, Mac and Linux, and for each computer you need one own license. I use a special version of AirPlayer. It is designed for the Raspberry Pi computer, and to be exact, there are also mobile versions, but I don't use them. Coming to my setup. I have three Raspberry Pi computers with AirPlayer on it. One Pi is connected to a 15.6 inch monitor, an old monitor from my laptop. The two others are connected to 5 inch monitors. The reason why I use the Raspberry Pis are that the Pis are cheap, they don't need much power, and you can run them easily remote. Of course, I could have used normal PCs instead. All three Raspberry Pis are connected via a switch to my LAN and can talk to my flight sim PC. So let's start the Air Manager software. It is installed on my main PC. Here you see the main menu where you could configure your local panels. I have some, but I don't use them. The next tab is for the instruments. You see there are currently 700 instruments available. There are freeware and payware ones. When you want to use an instrument, just click download. And well, here you see how many airspeed indicators are. The next tab is used for programming or editing your own instruments. I won't go into detail here. Next tab is the important tab. Here you find all your connected devices. By the way, you could also use Air Manager for configuring hardware inputs or outputs via an Arduino. I haven't tested it yet, so I can't tell you anything about that. Here you see my three devices. I have named them, and you can click on a device to see what panels are running. Each panel can have different parameters, like being loaded only when a certain aircraft is loaded, etc. So here you see my standard G5 panel. You can see some instruments have parameters you can change, so it's very versatile. The G5 is a payware instrument, so it has a lot of parameters. Now we want to add an airspeed indicator. So I click on Add Instrument, then I search for the airspeed indicator and add one. Now you see it in the WYSIWYG editor. You can drag it and resize it, and when you're happy with its position, you click on Save. Now the panel is uploaded to the AirPlayer's device and you're done. Well, of course, you can also enter values manually. To demonstrate that, I switch to my engine monitoring panel. Here, the original instrument is too small and has a frame, so I have resized it and positioned it to a negative coordinate so that it fits better into my panel. It is very important that you shut down your devices via the Air Manager software. Therefore, you just click on the button Shut Down All, and then they will all be shut down. When you power on the AirPlayer the next time, it will load the desired panel. If you're using another version than the Raspberry version, of course you can shut down it directly, but so you don't need to connect a keyboard or a mouse to it. Well, that's all about my Air Manager setup. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you like it, please subscribe to my channel. If you've got any questions, please post them in the comments section. Have a nice day and happy landings!